What's going on, y'all? Hope all is well. I'm Lando Success. Usually I talk about finance on this channel, but with the economy going down, I don't always want to talk about finance because it's doom and gloom sometimes. So we're switching it up a little bit and we will be talking about some daily news or life events, what's basically going on. If you don't want to see that content, just hit that like button and wait for the next video and we'll talk about crypto and stocks. So today I was in a gym and I seen this go across the screen where they found 50 dead bodies or 50 bodies in total in San Antonio. So this article on WMTW.com say 50 dead after trailer of migrants abandoned in Texas heat. And you know how hot it is right there. So let's check out this video and see what they're talking about.
So the plight of migrants seeking refuge is always a humanitarian crisis, but tonight we are dealing with a horrific human tragedy.
A worker who is works in one of the buildings up here behind me heard a cry for help, came out to investigate, found a trailer with the doors partially open, opened them up to take a look, and found a number of deceased individuals inside.
Engine 52 arrived and found the trailer, as Chief McManus mentioned, with a body outside and several that they could visibly see inside once the doors were opened. At this time, we have processed approximately 46 bodies that have been triaged and tagged and declared deceased at this time.
It's tragic. You know, there are, that we know of, 46 individuals who are no longer with us, who had families, who were likely trying to find a better life.
Fortunately, we were able to transport 16 people. 12 of those are adults and 4 pediatric. All of them were conscious at the time upon transportation. The patients that we saw were hot to the touch. They were suffering from heat stroke, heat exhaustion. No signs of water in the vehicle. It was a refrigerated tractor trailer, but there was no visible working AC unit on that rig.
We have 3 people in custody. We don't know if they are absolutely connected to this or not. This investigation has been turned over to HSI. It is now a federal investigation.
We hope that those responsible are prosecuted to the fullest extent of the law.
We're not supposed to open up a truck and see stacks of bodies in there. None of us come to work imagining that.
Wow. That's really, it's a lot to unpack right there, if you ask me, because I have so many questions. It's like, first, riding, have you ever been in back of a tractor trailer? Them things are hot or very cold, depending on the temperature. If you're in San Antonio, that thing is probably 140 degrees in there. So nobody going to survive. And you have a lot of different areas. First, you want to know, were they being transported from Mexico to the United States? Next thing you wonder, was it human trafficking? I honestly don't, well, I don't know. Nobody know yet. But it seemed hard to be human trafficking where you have 50 individuals. I believe they said 36 of them was men to be able to get on out of there. And it's going to be hard to human traffic 50 people at once. So it seemed like they was trying to come to America and make a better life for themselves. But I don't technically know. So let's read on a little bit. And for those that don't understand, because I've been all over, if you look at the map and you look at Texas, right, and you go down to San Antonio, San Antonio is not far from Mexico. I've been to Leon. Leon got a nice football stadium over there. Monterey. And it's really not that hard because they don't have like no real. That's when Trump was trying to like build the walls. So it's not like something from stopping people to come over. But when you come over in a semi, or I don't know if you already was over here, but being in a semi, that make it a lot more interesting. So you really have to read on to get a further understanding of what's going on, right? 50 migrants are dead after day and others was found in terrible conditions in a semi truck in San Antonio. U.S. Immigration and Customs Enforcement spokesman said. The death toll, which the city's fire chief has given on Monday, as 46 include migrants from Mexico, Guatemala, and Honduras. According to the federal law enforcement official who spoke on the conditions of anonymity, the discovery came as the U.S. federal authorities have launched what they describe as an unprecedented operation to disrupt human smuggling. So they have it under as a human smuggling, human trafficking thing. Networks and influx of migrants at the U.S.-Mexico border. An alleged human smuggling, so now they say alleged right there, was alerted by San Antonio Police Department when somebody basically said something about it. And they even had some children in there. 12 adults and 4 children was taken alive and conscious to the medical facilities. And they say you was touching them and they just burning hot in the water inside it. Hopefully if they are still alive, we can really find out and see what's going on. And you have Biden, he said his piece. Let's see. President Joe Biden described the discovery as horrifying and heartbreaking, saying the deaths underscored the need to go after criminal trafficking rings. Exploiting vulnerable individuals for profit is shameful, as the political grandstanding around tragedy, and my mission will continue to do everything possible to stop human smuggling. So they keep on saying human smuggling. So my other camera just went out. But completely keep it 100 with me. What's y'all thoughts? Do y'all believe this is human trafficking? Or do you believe people is trying to escape to come over to U.S.? I'm more on that side. And because they keep on saying human trafficking, I definitely could be wrong. I don't know. I want to know y'all thoughts in the comments. Try to keep it peaceful, because when you say something crazy, YouTube is going to be monitoring and going to make the comments disappear. Hit that like button, hit that subscribe button. God bless all the people that lost a lot of family members just trying to make it over here or being trafficked. This is a terrible event. Hope all is well though for everybody.